Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Good morning.
So in the Chicago viewing area or the general Chicago area, I think people are wondering how long before we can get rid of indoor masks and maybe vaccination mandates at restaurants?
Well, not long. These numbers are really plummeting. It's the same thing that happened in South Africa, so there's really no surprise. The faster you go up, the faster you go down. However, look at these. The number is still a little bit high, 8,665 new cases. In November, we would have been, you know, screaming about this, but it's going in the right direction. The problem always is letting up on these mitigations, the masking and everything else, too soon. We need to get it really down, and then we can all be free and get rid of all these rules.
We always looked at what's happening in other places first. Where is it, like Austria, that they're tightening restrictions? Yep. What's going on there? Is that something we should worry about?
We're already talking, as we're still with 9,000, almost 9,000 cases a day, the Europeans are experiencing the same drop, and they're tightening the rules. They want this thing to be gone. In Austria, it is not a law. You have to be vaccinated, unless there's some real medical reason why you can't. In France, you still can't get a cup of coffee without a vaccine card, even sitting outside. And you must wear your mask outside if you're in the public. So, you know, some places are getting tighter, and the United States is already talking about loosening up. We'll see which is the best approach.
All right, let's get to questions. When a person has COVID, how long until they can get it again? 30 days, 60 days, 90 days?
The typical is 90 days. Now, there was a little change when we went from Delta to Omicron. There was no protection from Delta for Omicron, so people were getting it a week or two or a month later. But from variant, within the same variant, is typically 90 days.
Okay, next question. Fast forward to this summer. Do the unvaccinated have to worry about being in a large indoor crowd?
Good question. Question of the day today, anyway. Probably not if things keep going this well, if we don't give up too soon.
All right, here's another question. Why hasn't Pfizer tested upping the dose for the first two shots of the vaccine for kids 2 to 4, since the vaccine for the 6 months to 2-year-old vaccine group is reported to work much better? Why didn't Pfizer jump to testing a third shot for this group instead?
Well, that's a good, actually, scientific question, what can be done. They're typically afraid to give too big a dose to really small kids. And so that's not the only way to improve the outcome. The extra dose is the way they feel is the safest way to go forward.
All right. Can COVID vaccinations elevate blood pressure?
Not typically, no. This has been looked at with many different vaccines. However, if someone really feels that it was temporarily related to when they got the vaccine, they should fill out one of those FDA VAERS report, V-A-E-R-S. They're easily to obtain online.
All right. So if you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or go to our Morning News Facebook page and post it there. We'll talk to him again on Monday. Have a good weekend, doctor.
Great. Have a great weekend.